A very good evening, everyone. And like I said, after a wonderful inaugural ceremony in the morning, some brainstorming and insightful sessions throughout the day, we are now all set for the prestigious India Sports Awards. This is Deeksha Tiwari, once again, welcoming you all to FICCI India Sports Awards as part of FICCI Turf 2020, the 10th edition of the Global Sports Summit. As you all would be aware, these awards are an attempt by FICCI to applaud the achievements and contribution of Indian athletes and various stakeholders of the ecosystem who have done noteworthy work to promote sports and bring pride to our nation. And while the awards ceremony may be virtual, let's all, like I said, keep our energy levels real during this entire ceremony. So I want everyone to put their best, not foot, but smile forward during the entire ceremony, because I think that would be the best possible applause for all our winners here. Of course, you can clap as well, but with your microphones muted. So that is the new way of clapping in this new normal. So let's get started. I would, in fact, request Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, President FICCI and Joint MD Apollo Hospital Group, to start with the first set of awards. So we would just start with, are we ready for this? We start with the best state promoting sports. And I would like to inform here that it's a tie, because we have joint winners here. The jury was it was a tough decision for the jury members. And so we have two states, two winners, joint winners here. And we start with our first, both the states. Let me just announce the names. That's Madhya Pradesh and Assam. So like I said, you can applaud at wherever you are. Yes, at least we can see you. So yes, absolutely. So so we start with Madhya Pradesh. The state has been known for its promotion and development of sports and sportspersons. For example, after the corona pandemic, the sports department has put in place a bio bubble so that athletes can train without fear of the virus. Over 257 athletes from various domains are training in the Itoki Stadium, where the bio bubble has been created for the last 5 months. We were really privileged to have Srimati Yashodhara Raj Sindhya, Honorable Minister, Department of Sports and Youth Welfare, Technical Education, Skill Development and Employment, Government of Madhya Pradesh, with us for the inaugural session. And it gives us great pleasure that she would be receiving the award on behalf of her state. So over to you, ma'am, for a few words.
Diksha, are you calling me or are you calling Ms. Rajay? You're calling Honorable Minister. You're on mute now, Diksha.
Diksha, you're on mute, please.
I'm so sorry. I had just done it after. So I would request, ma'am, you to, of course, officially, welcome her and to receive the award. And then we would like to hear a few words from her as well, the Honorable Minister.
To our Honorable Minister, Ms. Yashodhara Raje Sindhya Ji, we are extremely privileged to be able to give you this award. We heard your inspiring story this morning of how a young state did so much in the promotion of sports and how you have personally spearheaded it. It is a moment of sincere appreciation that we are able to recognize this tremendous impact that you have made in your state and through the work of your state to the country at large. So congratulations, ma'am. And genuinely on behalf of all of us at FICCI, please keep up the good work in the interest of our country and the youth so that sports becomes something as a mainstay program for everyone. Congratulations to you as a great role model. Namaste.
Principal Secretary, Mr. Pankaj Rag, and my DG, Kapan Jain, the Director of Sports, I accept this wonderful honor from FICCI. I'm so happy to be a part of the RICCI program, but I'm also happy that the RICCI industry organization is recognizing what Madhya Pradesh has done in its contribution towards sports in India. and we will continue to be at it because we do believe, all of us, in what we are doing. It is not just a promotion of sports, but it's a promotion of not just health, it's a promotion of our own country's glory, our own country's honor. And therefore, it is much more involved than just a health issue or to keep fit. We want to get the glory for our country. And if it is Madhya Pradesh that's going to help in doing that, so be it. Thank you very much for honoring the department. And once again, I want to thank my government, principal secretary and director, and all the people under in the directorate who have helped me in realizing, in getting this award today. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. And I think what we will now do, just to make it easier for all our presenters as well as the awardees, so I'll, from now on, Dr. Reddy, I'll be announcing the category. I would want you to announce the winners. Then I will talk about the winners and then hear from them. I think that should be a flow that we can maintain. And of course, we already know there's a joint winner here. So it's the other state we are talking about is Assam, which of course hosted the Khelo India Youth Games earlier this year, has been in the recording to be the sports hub of the country and meticulously planning international and national sports events. Just last week, Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Sri Sarbananda Sonowal, announced that to encourage people across every age group to inculcate sports in their daily lives and to unearth hidden talents in the grassroots, Assam will organize village Olympics across the state. And that's, I think, wonderful. So I'll of course, we have with us Sri Onkar Kedia, DG Sports Authority of Assam, here with us. But I will, of course, request Dr. Reddy to speak a few words and then request Sri Kedia to also receive the award on behalf of IKI and speak a few words. Over to you, ma'am.
Director General Sri Onkar Kedia ji, it's a pleasure to see you and to hear that you have won this award, and congratulations to you and your state being among the special states of the Northeast. We realize the pro-athletic nature of your population, and I think it's only fitting that you are focusing on sport. So all the very best and congratulations. Namaste.
Thank you. We'll request Sri Kedia ji to also speak a few words here.
Thank you. It is slightly unfortunate that Honorable Chief Minister Sri Sarbananda Sonowal, who is also the sports minister, could not attend this ceremony, although he very much wanted to because of his preoccupations. But he has conveyed his gratitude to the jury and to FICCI for choosing Assam as one of the two states promoting sports in the country. As you know, Mr. Sonowal is a big sports lover. He was also the Union Minister of Sports, and he's also having the sports portfolio with him now in Assam. He has taken a series of steps to boost sports in the state. We held a very successful Khelo India Youth Games earlier this year, where we had participation by around 8,000 players and technical officials. We perhaps organized the first state-level competition during the current pandemic in Guwahati. And we have taken up an ambitious scheme to build 500 play fields across the state. Our major sports complexes are coming up in Dibrugarh district, in North Lakhimpur district, and also in Kamrup district. So all these steps are being taken on behalf of Mr. Sonowal and on behalf of the government of Assam. I again convey thanks to FICCI and to the jury for selecting us. And this will inspire us and encourage us to do much more in future. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. We'll move on to the next category, and we'll, of course, I'll request Dr. Reddy to announce the winner. That's her way of presenting it, and then we'll, of course, move on to the awardee. So this one, the category is Best Organization Contributing in Sports Through CSR. I'm sure no prizes for guessing. Dr. Reddy, if you can announce the winner, please.
So I have great pleasure in congratulating Tata Steel for winning this award. It was the Best Organization CSR. And Tata Steel is represented today by Chanakya Chowdhury, VP Tata Steel. So congratulations and all the best. Tata is a company with a name across the country. It's only befitting that you're winning something in one more category. All the best. Diksha, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you. Very rightly said. Sports is a way of life for Tata Steel, an Indian multinational steelmaking company, subsidiary of the Tata Group. It's among the top steel producing companies in the world and is the world's most geographically diversified steel producers with operation and commercial presence across the world. We are definitely elated to present them the award of Best Organization Contributing Through Sports CSR. And yes, ma'am has already mentioned, we have with us Shri Chanakya Chowdhury, VP Tata Steel. So I'll request him to receive the award and speak a few words as well. Do we have Mr. Chowdhury with us here?
Good evening. Yes. I thought I was unmuted, but thank you, Diksha. Dr. Reddy, and okay. I'm very happy that aapne jab hamara CSR ka award announce kiya hai, to hamare Mukhyamantri ji Jharkhand ke, Mr. Hemant Soren has also logged in. So I can see him, and it's a great pleasure to receive this award. I think community and Tata Steel.
Congratulations, Chowdhury ji.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. And community and Tata Steel go hand in hand. We are two sides of the same coin. We are not different. And as in Tata Steel 100 years legacy, we always say sports is a way of life. That's the right way of connecting with people. And it has obviously grown over a period of time. It's only very humbling for me to receive this award from all of you and the jury. I must thank all of you. And also gives us the confidence. And I must say that we are on the right track. We've set up a lot of academies, our infrastructure, sports events, and we'll continue this on this path. And I must thank the team, the sports team in Tata Steel and the CSR team who work together to make this a success. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And so you've already pointed out, so we'd like to give a warm welcome to Honorable Chief Minister Jharkhand Shri Hemant Soren. And of course, since we have started this set of awards, Namaskar, sir. So pleasure to have you, really privileged. Since we have started this set of awards, we would continue with the next one, which is Best Company Promoting Sports in Public Sector. Ma'am, over to you to announce the winner.
So first, let me add my welcome to the Honorable Chief Minister of Jharkhand, Mr. Hemant Soren. Sorenji, we are extremely privileged.
Namaskar,
thank you so much for coming. And your presence here shows the importance you give to this very important subject of sports. So thank you for being here. Going on with the award ceremony, the best company promoting sports in the public sector is again very rightly chosen as the Indian Air Force. And the Air Force is today presented by the chairman of the Sports Promotion Board, Mr. Ashutosh Chowdhury. So let's give it up for the Air Force.
Absolutely. You know, it's the air arm of the Indian Armed Forces to complement of personnel and aircraft assets, ranks fourth amongst the air forces of the world. Their extraordinary contribution towards sport is worth awarding them as the best organization contributing through sports CSR public sector. And like we know, we have Mr. Ashutosh Chaturvedi, Chairman Sports Promotion Board, to receive the award. I'll request him to speak a few words here.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Air Force Sports Control Board, I humbly accept this award and thank the jury, also the Thank you so much. We are at a level best at Air Force to promote sports and construct the best of the infra for the sportsmen. And we are very sure that in coming years, we will achieve more milestones. Just to tell you, this gap of 25 years, our three athletes are now qualified for the Tokyo Olympics. It's a great achievement. And I'm sure this award will further motivate us to do more and better in terms of all the providing facilities to in all discipline in the future. Thank you very much once again. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Jai Hind, sir. Thank you so much. Well, I will request, I think certain microphones are still on, so if you can switch it off. There's a lot of background noise. Thank you so much. So moving on, the next one is best company promoting sports in private sector. Over to you, Dr. Reddy, to announce the winner.
So it gives me a special pleasure to announce the winner in this category as Tenvik Sports. And Tenvik Sports is represented by no other than Mr. Anil Kumble as the co-founder. And Anil Kumble, our former Indian cricketer, coach, commentator, is someone who's very famous right arm leg spin bowler that nobody will forget. In fact, I remember my young sons who are cricketers themselves saying when Kumble is there, then wickets will tumble. So Kumble and tumble would happen. So it's a great pleasure to see you, Kumbleji, and congratulations.
Thank you. Well, absolutely. Tenvik Sports Education Private Limited was founded with the vision of positively impacting the lives of people in and through sports. Extensively worked in areas of grassroots sports, lessons from sports, technology, and branding in sports. We are elated to present them the award of best company promoting sports in private sector. And like Dr. Reddy has very rightly said, we have the co-founder and one of the cricketing legends of India, Sri Anil Kumble, to receive the award. So could you spin some magic here as well?
Thank you so much, Honorable Chief Minister of Jharkhand, Sri Hemant Soren.
Congratulations, Kumbleji.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, President Fiki, thank you so much for your gracious words. Distinguished dignitaries and other fellow sportsperson who are all here, congratulations to all the winners. At the outset, I'm delighted to be present, albeit virtually, to accept this honor, the prestigious Fiki India Sports Award in the category of Best Company Promoting Sports in the Private Sector on behalf of my team at Tenvik Sports Education. My co-founder, Vasant Bharadwaj, a former Indian Table Tennis International, and I firmly believe that expanding the base at the grassroots level is the key to transforming India into a sporting nation and thereby a sporting superpower. We at Tenvik endeavor towards bringing a million children into sport in the immediate foreseeable future. I take this opportunity to thank Fiki and the jury led by an eminent judge in Justice Mukul Mudgal for this honor. It's such recognition that motivates us to remain committed to a cause that goes beyond mere business for profit. It's only befitting to acknowledge organizations and people that have encouraged and nurtured Tenvik in our journey. Our angel customer, the KLE Group of Institutions, the Government of Odisha, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Government of Chhattisgarh, our advisors, our employees, vendors, suppliers, and many others that have been instrumental in establishing a structured sports training at the grassroots level. Thank you so much for this great honor. We respect, we humbly accept this award. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. It's actually a pleasure to hear from you. And of course, we had started with the first set of awards, but like I said, there's nothing without, you can't start a ceremony without the inaugural address. So now, since our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Hemant Soren, is here with us, I would request, she's a global healthcare influencer. She's a healthcare technocrat, a social entrepreneur, and above all, a humanitarian. She has been on the forefront during this challenging period to work towards the vision that FICCI stands for, to be a definite voice for the industry to assist in the growth and development of the country. So I'll request the president of FICCI now, Dr. Sangeeta Reddy to present the inaugural address.
Namaste and good evening. It is my genuine pleasure to welcome all participants, jury members and awardees today for the 7th FICCI India Sports Award. Honorable Chief Minister, thank you for allowing us to finish the category and then come to the formal welcome address. It is indeed such a pleasure to welcome you. And like I said earlier, your presence here is testimony to the importance that you give to sports. And I believe that this is reflected in the positivity, the energy, and the vigor of your life and your leadership. And also the thoughts which you continue to convey, and we look forward to hearing you very soon. We're also thankful to the state for inviting FICCI to support sports development in the state, and we're very excited to be working with your team very shortly. I think all of us understand and appreciate the extent of the disruption which has happened because of the unprecedented impact of the COVID-19. And yet we must find ways to move forward, whether we're innovating with platforms like these or finding ways to bring fitness in different manners into our own personal lives. Each one of us has stood up, risen to the occasion, and found one important fact, and that is that humanity and nurturing of life is more important than anything else. And since sports is so much a part of positive life, we look forward to encouraging this sincere and genuine endeavor. I also think that the impact of sports on society is multidimensional. Not only does it enable physical fitness, and this morning we spoke about lifelong fitness as we propel lifelong learning, but the impact is also on the positivity of the mind, because a healthy mind is something which can impact the entire society. Through these awards, FICCI looks to acknowledge the contribution and to facilitate sports achievers of various stakeholders, whether they're companies, corporates, coaches, governments, or even and the sportsmen themselves. So we will continue to do this because we truly believe in the power of sports to transform society and, of course, to bring glory to the nation. I would like to thank the jury members, as I conclude, for sparing their time to help us organize these awards and to sincerely, meticulously, and in a most unbiased manner go through and come up with this. I also welcome tomorrow's sessions to start with the sessions titled Sports for Holistic Development and Prospective Career. As I said earlier, many mothers or parents hesitate to make sports a career for their children. It's time for us in India to change and to make sports a part of life and to be genuinely accepted. With these few words, let me once again join the entire audience in welcoming Sri Hemant Soren Ji, Honorable Chief Minister of Jharkhand, for his keynote address. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I think, like very rightly said, we are very privileged that we have with us Honorable Chief Minister Jharkhand, Sri Hemant Soren. Of course, known for his pro-people reforms and progressiveness, he has laid special emphasis on promotion of sports in Jharkhand, and it will be a privilege to now hear from him. Over to you, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
पहले तो मैं आप सब लोगों को बहुत बहुत आभार धन्यवाद देता हूँ, विशेषकर संगीता रेड्डी जी को, कि मुझे भी आप लोगों ने आज इस अवार्ड का एक हिस्सा बनाया. और पहले तो जिन लोगों को अवार्ड मिला उन सबको बहुत सारी शुभकामनाएं हमारी तरफ से, और फिक्की के पूरे टीम को कि आप इस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन में भी एक ऐसे सब्जेक्ट को लेकर आगे बढ़ रहे हैं जिसको लेकर डेफिनेटली काफ़ी उत्साह यंग जनरेशन यूथ को और इससे जुड़े लोगों को हो रहा होगा. और खेल जगत में निश्चित रूप से इस पैंडमिक सिचुएशन में काफ़ी चिंताएं रही हैं, और जिस तरीके से लास्ट एक साल से हम अप एंड डाउन देख रहे हैं, और खिलाड़ियों का काफ़ी मनोबल काफ़ी उदास था, लेकिन इस दौरान हमने भी काफ़ी प्रयास किया कि कैसे इस खेल के क्षेत्र में हम आगे बढ़ें। और आप सब लोगों को मालूम है, यहाँ कुंबले जी भी हैं जिनको अवार्ड मिला। हमारा ये झारखंड प्रदेश ऐसे ही स्पोर्ट्स के मामले में वो इंटरनल वो अपने आप में इतना एनर्जेटिक रहा है कि जहाँ से हम धोनी जैसे प्लेयर को भी यहाँ देश को देते हैं, और ऐसे कई खिलाड़ी हमारे राज्यों से निकलते हैं जो पूरा देश का नाम रोशन भी कर रहे हैं। और मेरी चिंताएं भी है, और इस बार मैं बहुत प्रयासरत हूं कि स्पोर्ट्स को लेकर हम एक लंबी लकीर खींचे, और इसको लेकर हमारा विभाग लगातार काम में लगा हुआ है, और इसके लिए फिक्की के भी बहुत बड़ा योगदान हम देख रहे हैं, और पार्टनर भी होने के वजह से मुझे खुशी है कि जिस उद्देश्य के साथ मैं खेल की दुनिया की और आगे देखने की कोशिश कर रहा हूं, वो लक्ष्य जरूर आप लोगों के सहयोग से हम अचीव करेंगे। आज ये अवार्ड सेरेमनी में कि हम लोग आमतौर पर जो खिलाड़ियों का उत्साह आमने सामने बैठकर होता है, एक चुनौती है कि हम लोग ऑनलाइन आज एक दूसरे से कनेक्टेड हैं, बट कोई नहीं, अब इस पैंडेमिक में कनेक्टिविटी बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है। इन फ्यूचर ये को देखते हुए, स्थिति को देखते हुए, और मैं उम्मीद करूंगा कि जितने भी खेल जगत से जुड़े लोग हैं, चाहे वो उद्योग घराने से हो, पेशेवर खिलाड़ी हो, या फिर विभिन्न राज्यों के जो प्रबुद्ध लोग हैं जो खेल जगत से जुड़े हैं, उन सभी लोगों को आज के इस अवार्ड सेरेमनी निश्चित रूप से देख ही रहे होंगे, और अभी तो शुरुआत है, हमें एक लंबी लकीर खींचनी है, और विशेषकर हम देश के पैमाने में भी अलग अलग स्पोर्ट्स को लेकर हम लोग अपना एक अलग पोजीशन एस्टेब्लिश कर सकते हैं, मैं ऐसा उम्मीद करता हूं। और इस छोटे से कार्यक्रम में, छोटे से समय में आप लोगों से, आप लोगों के इस विशेष कार्यक्रम के लिए मैं बहुत धन्यवाद भी देता हूं, और आप जितने भी उपस्थित सदस्य हैं, सब लोगों को मैं अपने स्टेट में स्पोर्ट्स को बढ़ावा देने के लिए जो सुझाव हो सकते हैं, जो आपके मार्गदर्शन हो सकते हैं, मैं आपको आमंत्रण भी करूंगा, आप लोगों को इनवाइट भी करता हूं कि आप हमारे राज्य में आएं। यहां सिर्फ माइंस मिनरल्स ही नहीं, खूबसूरत वादियां भी हैं, यहां बहुत सारे खिलाड़ियां भी हैं, और काफ़ी, चाहे फुटबॉल हो, हॉकी हो, क्रिकेट हो, एंड आर्चरीज हो, इन सब जगहों पर आपने हमारे देश के नौजवानों का जौहर देखा ही है, और मैं उम्मीद करूंगा कि ये चीज़ें और आगे फ्लोरिश करें, इसके लिए आप लोगों की हम जरूर सहयोग लेंगे। अंत में मैं टिक्की के सभी सदस्यों को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, आभार प्रकट करता हूं कि आज आप लोगों ने यह अवार्ड सेरेमनी में मुझे आमंत्रण किया, और मुझे कुछ बोलने का भी मौका दिया, आप लोगों से इंटरेक्शन करने करके मुझे काफ़ी खुशी मिली, और आगे भी मुझे लगता है कि ऐसे हम लोग एक दूसरे के संपर्क में रहें, ताकि एक अच्छे रास्ते तय किए जा सके, अच्छे पॉलिसीज बनाए जा सके, यंग जनरेशन को स्पोर्ट्स के क्षेत्र में इंक्रेज किया जा सके, उनको हम लोग अधिक से अधिक कैसे डेवलप कर पाए और दूसरे देशों के बराबर में। इन्हीं बातों के साथ बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आप सबको, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सो मच, शुक्रिया सर,
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, थैंक यू।
एब्सोल्युटली थैंक यू सो मच, काफी एनकरेजिंग रहेगा आई एम श्योर जो भी आपने कहा, और झारखंड के लिए तो न्योता मिल ही गया हम सबको यहाँ पे, सो आई वी नो व्हाट्स आवर नेक्स्ट डेस्टिनेशन गोइंग टू बी. थैंक यू सो मच सर. वेल सर, अभी मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी टू गिव अवे ऑल्सो अवार्ड. सो मैं सर कैटेगरी बताऊंगी और आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू अनाउंस द नेम ऑफ द विनर सर. तो हाँ जी सर, तो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ द फर्स्ट वन हियर. दिस इज फॉर बेस्ट नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स फेडरेशन. मैं ऑनरेबल सीएम साहब से विनती करूंगी.
Best Western Sports Federation is Western Federation of India Paralympic Committee of India. यही है ना?
जी 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 सर. Yes, we have two joint winners again. Jury, a tough time here. So Paralympic Committee of India and Wrestling Federation of India. The Paralympic, of course, Committee of India is a non-partisan, non-profit organization dedicated for development and upliftment of physically challenged sports, athletes with mobility, disability, amputation, blindness, and cerebral palsy. This committee's exemplary contribution towards para-athletes has awarded them this award of Best National Sports Federation. We had, in fact, Dr. Deepa Malik, president, in the beginning, but of course, unhone kaha tha that she has another meeting which, for which I think we have a representative from the committee. So I'll request him to please speak a few words.
Yeh bhi bolna
hai. Manjusha Kanwar.
Manjusha Kanwar.
यहाँ पे इज अ समवन फ्रॉम द पैरा ओलंपिक कमिटी हियर. ऑफ कोर्स दीपा जी हैड गिवन हर रिगार्ड्स. ऑलराइट, आई थिंक वी विल टेक हर मैसेज दैट शी हैड गिवन इन द बिगिनिंग एंड वी वुड लाइक टू. यस यस, दिस इज ऑफ कोर्स नीडेड फॉर द वंडरफुल वर्क दैट दे आर डूइंग फॉर पैरा एथलीट्स. And moving on to the other joint winner in this category, Wrestling Federation of India, governing body of wrestling in India, dedicated for development of wrestlers in India. They promote, develop, and encourage development of game wrestling. And we have with us P.N. Prasood, Secretary General of WFI. So I'll request him to receive the award and speak a few words. Right. Do we have with us Mr. B.N. Prasood? Yes, sir. You, sir, I think your microphone, you will have to unmute, sir. I can, I have located you, sir. It's still on mute, sir. There's a red sign microphone. If you just click on it, sir. I think Mr. Prasood is facing a little bit of problem, but sir, we can come back to him as he sorts it out. So we will, we will of course hear a few words from him. Then I think okay, there's someone who's come to assist him and help him. Okay, yes, sir.
Hello. Yes.
Yes. Yes,
okay.
Sir. Good. Good.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Sir. Wonderful.
Respected Chief Minister Jharkhand and other district. As your distinguished guests, those who are attending the meeting. Actually, first of all, on behalf of the Wrestling Federation of India, I am heartily thanks to the organizers and the committee members of FICCI for selecting us as the best sports federation in 2020. These achievements will definitely be a high motivation for the federation as well as the wrestlers and members of the WFI. I would like to present this award to our dynamic leader, President of Wrestling Federation of India, Sri Brijbhushan Saran Singh Ji, Member of Parliament for his devoted contribution of the achievements in the field of wrestling. And I would like to thank to the each and every members of the WFA family. Once more, I thank to the organizers and the committee members of FICCI. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you. So much, sir. Okay, I think Mr. Sakti Narayan from Paralympic Committee is here with us. Mr. Sakti Narayan, if you're there, you can speak a few words here. Is Mr. Sakti Narayan here? Okay, these are the technical problems of handling a virtual award ceremony, because in front of you there's one screen and there are more participants, so you actually have to search if someone is there or not, because I am trying to search.
I'm speaking on behalf of Dr. Deepa Malik. She had another engagement that she needed to be on, so I think Satyanarayan sir is having some technical difficulties. So I want to step in and say thank you to everyone here on behalf of Paralympic Committee of India, and thank Chief Minister sir for joining us and making the ceremony even more prestigious. Vicky and everyone else involved, the jury especially coming to this decision of felicitating Paralympic Committee of India. On behalf of the President, General Secretary, and the entire Paralympic Committee of India family, I thank everyone for this honor, and I do believe that it will encourage the Paralympic Committee of India to keep promoting their athletes, keep supporting their athletes, and bring back great laurels from the forthcoming Paralympic Games. And of course, keep up the spirit of the Paralympics, which is shown by our physically challenged athletes time and time again. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Keep up the good work and congratulations. So moving on to the next category, this one is Sportsperson of the Year Award. So I'll request our Honorable Chief Minister to now once again announce the winners. So ladies and gentlemen, these are technical difficulties. You have to bear with it. We will have these things which are very natural when you're doing a virtual award ceremony. Yes, sir. We have our Honorable Chief Minister back.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Sports person of the year, Bajrang Punia and Ila Venil.
Thank you. Okay, so we have our joint winners once again. Ila Venil, of course, a sports leader from Tamil Nadu. Thank you. And she represented India at the 2018 ISSF Junior World Cup, won a gold medal, then silver in World University Games in 2019, after which she won gold at World Junior World Cup 2019. We're definitely proud to announce her as a Sportsperson of the Year Award. And I have noticed that she has a beautiful smile. So, of course, we'll come back to Bajrang as well. But over to you, Ila Venil, to speak a few words here.
I hope everyone can hear me. A very good evening to all the eminent personalities present in this event. I would like to thank my family first for always standing by me. My mentor Gagan Narang and my coach Neha Chavan for always believing in me. The National Rifle Association of India for always supporting and pushing us through all our hard times, and the Sports Authority of India making sure that we are equipped with all the things even during the COVID. I would also like to thank my state, the state of Gujarat, and the Sports Authority of Gujarat for helping us from the grassroots levels and believing that we can achieve our best. And it is a great honor to be receiving this award in front of all these eminent personalities here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and lovely smile that you have. And I can say that shot through your heart straight. So moving on to the other joint winner that we have, Bajrang Punia, a freestyle wrestler from India, competes in 65 kg weight category, has won 3 medals at the World Wrestling Championship, has represented India at the World Championship and other global sporting events. Pride of Indian wrestling, and he's win, of course, the wins the Sports Person of the Year award. So over to you, Mr. Bajrang.
Hello, hello. Sun pa rahe hain aap?
हाँ जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सुन पा रहे हैं।
सभी को नमस्कार और हमारे साथ झारखंड के सीएम जुड़े हैं और बहुत सारे खिलाड़ी जुड़े हैं। मेरी तरफ से सभी को नमस्कार और मुझे इस अवार्ड के लिए चुना गया, मैं आप सभी का धन्यवाद करता हूं और आगे भी हम कोशिश करेंगे कि हम अपनी तरफ से बेस्ट करें और देश के लिए बहुत सारे मेडल जीते, क्योंकि हर खिलाड़ी जब भी कोई सम्मान मिलता है तो यही मोटिवेट होते हैं खिलाड़ी की भाई हम और अच्छा करें, क्योंकि देशवासी इतना प्यार और सम्मान देते हैं हमें। तो मैं आप सभी को धन्यवाद देता हूँ कि मुझे इस अवार्ड के लिए आपने
बहुत शुभकामनाएं।
धन्यवाद जी सीएम साहब जी, और मैं आप सभी का और जितने भी खिलाड़ी इसमें पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे थे उनका भी मैं बधाई देता हूं, और जिनको जिन्होंने इसमें जो अवार्ड जीते हैं उनको मैं शुभकामनाएं देता हूं कि आगे फ्यूचर में देश के लिए और बहुत सारे मेडल जीते, और इसी के लिए एक बार फिर से आपका धन्यवाद, क्योंकि मैं अभी यूएसए में हूं ट्रेनिंग पे, तो अभी मेरा ट्रेनिंग का टाइम है, तो मैं इसलिए आप ज्यादा समय नहीं ले पाऊंगा, तो आप सभी का एक बार फिर से धन्यवाद।
शुक्रिया, थैंक यू सो मच, धन्यवाद बजरंग जी, एंड एंड आप बिल्कुल ट्रेनिंग बहुत जरूरी है, आप यू कैन कंटिन्यू विद द ट्रेनिंग व्हाइल वी मूव ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी। एंड आई वंस अगेन रिक्वेस्ट हमारे ऑनरेबल सीएम साहब से मैं विनती करूंगी कि आप ये जो तीसरा कैटेगरी है उसका भी विन एंड अनाउंस करें। सो दिस वन इज ब्रेक थ्रू स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन ऑफ द ईयर अवार्ड। मैं हमारे ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर सर से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी टू अनाउंस द विनर।
या द अवार्ड गोज टू अनु रानी जी।
यस, अनु रानी इंडियन चैंपियन फॉर करंट नेशनल रिकॉर्ड होल्डर विद अ रिकॉर्ड ऑफ 62.34 मीटर इन मार्च 2019 वाज द फर्स्ट इंडियन वुमन टू क्रॉस अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 60 मीटर इन जैवलिन थ्रो एंड हैज ब्रोकन द नेशनल रिकॉर्ड मल्टीपल टाइम्स। Her excellent efforts and performance have made her the breakthrough sportsperson of the year award. So over to you, Anu ji, if you're, I mean, to receive the award and of course speak a few words here.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Hello.
Anji.
Sabhi. Namaskar. देश के लिए मेडल लेके आए और आप सभी का प्यार और आशीर्वाद ऐसे ही बना रहे। थैंक यू वेरी मच,
बहुत बहुत मुबारक।
थैंक यू अनुजी, थैंक यू, शुक्रिया, कांग्रेचुलेशंस। And I would also like to thank our Honorable Chief Minister for doing the honors and giving these awards. And thank you so much, sir. We are really grateful for your presence. आप यहाँ आए, आपने इतना inspire किया हम सभी को और ये awards देने के लिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।
My pleasure, बहुत अच्छा है, चलिए।
हाँ जी, so we will now move to the next set of awards. And for that, I would now request, we have one of our jury members here with us, Professor Dheeraj Sharma, Director, IIM Rohtak, and he's here with us. So I will now be requesting him to give away the next few awards. Dheeraj ji, can you hear us? Are you?
I can hear you. Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me.
All right. So I would be the same thing. I'll be mentioning the category and I would want you to announce the winners. So the category is Best NGO Promoting Sports.
The Best NGO Promoting Sports this year is Magic Bus, Rajesh SS from the Magic Bus and Gopi Chand Foundation. So it's a joint winner. Congratulations, Magic Bus and Gopi Chand Foundation.
Absolutely. Congratulations. Like I said, we have joint winners. Magic Bus India Foundation has made a difference to the lives of 1 million children and young people in the last 2 decades. They have done some, brought about some outstanding results through the programs by using sports and activity-based curriculum to break the cycle of poverty. Their extraordinary contribution towards sports is worth awarding them as the best NGO promoting sports. And we have with us Mr. Rajesh SS, Director, Magic Bus, here with us. So I would request him to receive the award and also speak a few words here.
Yeah, thank you, Diksha. Thanking Fikhi for recognizing Magic Bus Foundation and also many other sports organizations working towards the promotion of sports at the grassroots levels. It's also a great honor to be part of this program, having Chief Minister Mr. Hemant Soren, Dr. Sankita, Justice Mudgal, Anil Kumble, and various other dignitaries. I would also would like to congratulate Evelyn, Bajrang Punia, and Anurani for winning the coveted awards of FICCI. On behalf of Magic Bus, we thank you. We thank the jury for giving this award to Magic Bus. This award means a lot to us. It will give us an added impetus to program identified budding sportspersons from the underprivileged communities. We once again thank everyone and FICCI for this great honor to us. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Congratulations. Hope your wonderful journey in Magic Bus with Magic Bus continues. Like we said, we have a joint winner. So of course, we also have Pulela. Gopi Chand Badminton Foundation has and still giving back a lot to the sport of the badminton in India, which is of course not a secret. The foundation has trained, nurtured and guided young talent with purpose of developing international badminton champions. Their extraordinary contribution towards sport is worth awarding them as the best NGO promoting sports. Of course, we have with us the legendary Mr. Pulela Gopi Chand himself here with us to receive this award. So, sir, let's hear a few smashing words from you here.
Thank you very much, Diksha ji, and all of you, a very good evening. It's lovely to be here on this platform, to have the Honorable Chief Minister and many distinguished members present here. Would like on behalf of the entire Gopi Chand Foundation, the coaches, players and the entire team, would like to thank FICCI for the award, thank the jury for believing in us and thinking us worthy enough for the award. Thank you very much to the jury and FICCI for this award. Would also like to congratulate all the other winners, and in these trying times, FICCI to come out and support this kind of an event is really wonderful. Of course, a lot has happened to sport in the last few years, and I would like to thank the support of the Sports Authority of India, the Badminton Association of India, and the SAI, and the many sponsors for their continued trust and support in us. And and thank again, once again, the jury. And I only say that these kinds of awards ensure that we feel more responsible and put in a lot more work. Thank you very much for the honor. And truly, I hope that we can give much more back to the society. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. That's what I would say, humility personified. Thank you so much. Moving on, this one, of course, an important one. So the Lifetime Achievement Award. Over to you, Professor Janas Bina.
The Lifetime Achievement Award this year goes to Manjusha Kanwar. Congratulations, Manjusha.
Well, we've been talking about badminton. Female badminton player from India has won the national championship in India for the first time in 1991, and 9 more titles followed until 2002. On the international level, she's won silver at the South Asian Games 2004, and we are truly happy to present her with the Lifetime Achievement Award. So over to you, Manjusha ji, to receive the award and speak a few words here.
Yep. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Namaste to all the eminent dignitaries and all eminent sports persons It's indeed a pleasure to be here, and you know, it's been the scenes for so long that you know, it's a new a place for me to be back, you know, in front. And I just want to thank sincerely the entire organization, FICCI, and the entire jury for selecting me and awarding me the Lifetime Achievement Award for 2020. It means a lot to me. I want to thank my parents for you know, allowing me to continue my passion and never put any academic pressure on me, and so I could go on and play sports. I want to thank Indian Oil, the organization that supported me, gave me total financial support and allowed me to pursue my game. And after the game, also mentored me into a sports coordinator. So a huge thank you to my company, Indian Oil. Of course, there's so many people that I have helped me, who just for the love of the game, you know, selflessly, without asking for anything in return. And there's so many of my coaches and my entire team in Pune, you know, my brother and my husband, who actually wanted to play the way I played. And so every time I won, it was, you know, for them, it was like we three, you know, playing together. So this award is for them also. It means a lot to me. I dedicate this award to my coach, Gore sir, who's no more, who passed away this year, who taught me that you have to give back whatever you know. It is not for you to keep. You just keep learning. It's a journey, and whatever you know, you have to give back. And so I'm just, you know, living on that philosophy. This award will, just like, you know, everybody said, this award just gives me so much of encouragement to continue the path, to support others in the same way that I got support. And I hope I can continue to do good and support sports in everywhere. Thank you and namaste.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So, all right. So moving on to the next category. This one is Para Athletes of the Year. And I'll request Professor to do the honors.
The Para Athlete of the Year, again, there are joint winners. The two winners for Para Athlete of the Year award are Sundar Singh and Simran Sharma. Congratulations, Sundar, and congratulations, Simran. Wish you the very best.
Two winners, absolutely, and one in male and the other in the female category. And we have Sundar Singh Gujjar, an Indian Paralympic javelin thrower, shot putter and discus thrower, competing in F46 events, set a world record at the 16th Para-Athletics National Championship in Panchkula, holding three gold medals in three events. We are actually later to jointly presenting the Para-Athlete of the Year award. So over to you, Sundarji, if you are here with us. I would like you to hear a few words from you.
Sabhi ke liye, good evening. Mujhe FICCI award ke liye chuna gaya. Main apne FICCI ke liye, PCI ke liye, main dil se dhanyavad karta hun. Aur abhi main Tokyo Olympic ki taiyari kar raha hun, जो कोरोना वायरस की वजह से पोस्टपोन होकर 2021 में हो गया है, उसके लिए मैंने क्वालिफाई कर रखा है और उम्मीद है कि मैं उसमें देश के लिए गोल्ड मेडल जीत के आऊं। बहुत बहुत थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सो मच। एंड यस, वी हैव अनदर विनर, सिमरन शर्मा, पार्टिसिपेटेड इन 100 मीटर athlete category in World Para-Athletics Championship 2019, has also won gold medal in 100 meter in World Para-Athletics Grand Prix Beijing 2018, and I will now request her to receive the award and speak a few words.
Namaste. Thank you so much, FICCI, itna support karne ke liye, and thank you so much, PCI, AFI. Big thanks for Indian Army, mere ko itna support karne ke liye. Mere husband Indian Army mein hai, to आर्मी का बहुत बड़ा हाथ है यहाँ तक पहुँचाने के। थैंक यू सो मच, मेरी फैमिली मुझे इतना सपोर्ट करती है, और आपने मुझे इस अवार्ड के लिए चुना, ये मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है, और मैंने पैरालंपिक के लिए क्वालिफाई किया है, तो मैं अपनी कोशिश देश के लिए गोल्ड मेडल ला सकूं। सपोर्ट के लिए आप सबका थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू, बिल्कुल, थैंक यू सो मच, कांग्रेचुलेशंस एंड जय हिंद। वेल, थैंक यू प्रोफेसर फॉर डूइंग द ऑनर्स एंड गिविंग अवे द अवार्ड्स।
थैंक यू and wish you the very best, thank you to Fiki and congratulations to everybody.
Thank you. Well, we also have with us Justice Mukul Mudgal, who's the chair of the jury for India Sports Awards 2020. He's someone who has always supported Fiki, and we are really blessed and privileged that he's here with us today. Also former Chief Justice of Punjab and Haryana High Courts, of course, needs no introduction for a lot of us here, and privileged to have you here with us, sir, and over to you for the next set of awards. I'll be announcing the category, sir, and would request you to announce the winners. So the category next is Best Sports Journalist. So I'll request you to announce the name of the winner.
Before I start, I'd like to thank all my jury members. We had animated discussions, but eventually it was unanimous, all the awards, and I'm happy about that. And I must say, divulge one discussion which we had about 10-week sports. I didn't know that Mr. Kumble was behind 10-week sports. We only went by data. And since I'd watched his 10 wickets in Kotla live, it was a pleasure to award, pleasant surprise to find him here for 10 wick sports. And Pulela Gopichand, also both of them, and all the distinguished sports person who received the award, I must compliment them. Okay. Yes. Pona Parthasarathy is the best sport journalist of the year.
Thank you. Yes, a respected sports journalist with a series of accomplishments, a leading figure in sports circle, and is admired for her passionate reporting on almost every game. She's a regular expert on various digital and electronic platforms. Definitely, we are privileged to present the Sports Journalist Award to her. Over to you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Thank you so much. I would like to thank the jury, Mudgal sir, Fiki, for recognizing my effort in last two decades. I would also like to thank my family for allowing me to make a career in a male-dominated field, considering it's not a 9-to-5 job. Sports is one thing that brings positivity in life when there is so much negativity surrounding us. Sports person give their blood and sweat to bring laurels for the country. Anil sir is here, and I remember how he played with the broken jaw at Kotla and perfect 10. So congratulations, Anil sir. And it's our duty as a sports journalist to highlight those aspects of the sport also, not always being negative. So in my two decades as a sports journalist, I have tried hard to bring that positivity, the positivity of sports that reflect in my writing. So thank you so much. And agle saal Tokyo Olympic or Paralympic bhi hai. And I sincerely hope that our sports person bring a lot of medals एंड लॉरेंस और क्रिकेट वर्ल्ड कप भी है, तो मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ कि हम क्रिकेट का विश्व कप फिर से जीते, और एक बार फिर से फिक्की को और जूरी को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू, थैंक यू सो मच मोना जी। एंड नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी, दिस इज फॉर कोच और सपोर्ट स्टाफ द ईयर। आई विल रिक्वेस्ट जस्टिस मुद्गल टू डू द ऑनर्स प्लीज।
Chairman, you're on mute, sir. Justice Mudgal, you're on mute. Unmute yourself.
The sports journalist, coach of the year is Radhakrishnan Nair.
Yes, the chief coach at Athletic Federation of India, certified technical official and World Athletics Level 5 coach. He's the first Indian to have an International Coaching Enrichment Program certificate of the International Olympic Committee. We are elated to present him the coach of the year award. Over to you, sir, Mr. Nair, for receiving the award and also speaking a few words here.
Thank you very much. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much, respected distinguished dignitaries and the award winners, and especially the jury chairman and jury members. I'm so happy to be in this platform, and it is a passion for me, coaching, and but in my wife's words, it is fanatism. She says it is a fanatism always. Anyway, I'm very happy to see my Air Force Sports Control Board chairman, because I belong to Air Force Sports Control Board once upon a time. I was in Air Force for 20 years, and Air Force made me an athlete as well as a coach to this level. I thanks to Athletic Federation of India and Sports Authority of India to give me a platform to work. And I'm very happy to see Mr. Anil Kumble, and 10 Week Sports is a big word in my mind because they are doing a lot of grassroots level program. We are also supporting them. And Mr. Gopichand, many of the distinguished personalities are here, and one of my athletes also received, Mr. Anu Rani. Thank you so much. Thank you, Fikki. And it is a big motivation for me to work further higher. Thanks. Thanks to one and all. Thank you, Fikki.
Thank you so much, sir. And I would also like to thank Justice Mukul Mudgal for doing the honors. Thank you so much, sir. Privileged to have you with here. And we will now move on to our next category. For this, I would like to request Mr. Himanshu Raj, Head Brand Communications, MPL, to present the last set of awards, in fact.
Hi, thank you, Diksha. Thank you so much.
All right, so we will start the same process. I'm going to announce the category. We'll request you to give out the names of the winners. So the first one is Best Professional Services Company.
Okay, so the Best Professional Services Company goes to Collage Design.
All right, Collage Design Private Limited, a professional architecture firm offering integrated services to client aiming at delivering quality, value, innovation, and creativeness in its design. It has been sharing and developing ideas to ensure future-proof, responsible architecture. We are elated to present them with the Best Professional Services Company Award. And we have with us its director, Mr. Ram Subramanian, to receive the award. So I request him to now speak a few words.
Hi, Diksha, can you hear me?
Yes.
I'd like to thank Fikki for this honor. We have been very privileged to work and focus on the design of sports infrastructure across the country. And we have been we had the great opportunity to work across various states with various of the athletes to kind of improve the quality of infrastructure. And we really think this award is motivating us to improve on this quality and make the venues in our country to the highest standards. So we bring in more and more medals into the country. Thank you once again for this opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Of course, needless to mention, MPL is, of course, our award partner. And I would personally like to thank Mr. Himanshu as well. He's here with us, and for the wonderful support that MPL has provided to Fikki for this event. Thank you so much during these tough times. So, of course, moving on to the next category. This one is the Best Sports Startup.
So the Best Sports Startup goes to Sports Grid.
Wonderful. So that's Sports Grid for you, a sports social networking platform for finding or hosting sporting events, sports classes, coaches, forming teams, finding sports partners. The aim is to promote sports at the grassroots level, and they have brought every aspect of sports and made it local to your neighborhood. So we are elated to present them with the Best Sports Startup Award, and we have with us Mr. Tehseen from Sports Grid. So I'll request him to receive the award and speak a few words. I hope it's a him. Yes, it's a him. So you'll have to unmute, sir.
Nasim, can't hear you. We can't hear you.
Hello.
you'll have to log out and log in again.
And welcome to the virtual world. So I, like I said, these are issues that we face. Mr. Tessing, why don't you log out and log in again while we continue, and then once you log in back, we'll of course take a few words from you as well. So moving on to the next category, we'll of course shortly have Mr. Tessing back with us. This one is Best Educational Institute Promoting Sports in the category of University. Over to you, Mr. Manshu.
The Best Educational Institute Promoting Sports at the university level goes to Manav Rachna Institutions.
Wonderful. So Manav Rachna International Institute of Research and Studies is a continuum of excellence. The academy is an unparalleled sports experience which offers sports to an enthusiast who believes in taking the sporting excellence to a brand new level with world-class infrastructure, best training teachers and sports clinics. We are elated to present them with the Best Educational Institute Promoting Sports in the University category. Of course, we have with us Dr. Amit Bhalla, the Vice President of Manav Rachna. He was here with us for the inaugural ceremony as well. So over to you, Dr. Bhalla.
Thank you very much, Diksha ji. On behalf of Team Manav Rachna, I very gracefully accept this award and would like to thank Fiki and the jury members for selecting Manav Rachna for this award. It is really motivating for an educational institution to get an award from Fiki, which represents the industry. I would like to thank my friend and my mentor, a mentor for Manav Rachna Institutions, Mr. Ranjan Sodhi, for his support in building Manav Rachna what it is today in the field of sports. And of course, our director of sports, Mr. Sarkar Talwar, and his entire team of coaches who are working towards achieving our dream of getting an Olympic medal from a student who starts his sports career with Manav Rachna Institutions. And would like to thank the parents who have always believed in Manav Rachna, who have always believed in the value system, who have always believed in the training programs across all our institutions. Would once again like to thank everyone and would like to congratulate all winners and would like to thank the jury once again for giving us this honor and this award. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Bhalla. Congratulations. And last but not the least, Best Education Institute Promoting Sports in the School category. Over to you, Mr. Manchu.
Mute.
Yeah, so the Best Educational Institute Promoting Sports at the school level goes to the Sports School.
Yes, Sports School, India's first integrated school for sports and education with world-class facilities and training, a 27-acre campus and state-of-the-art sporting infrastructure with sporting partners like Pulela Gopichand, Rohan Panna, Bengaluru FC, Robin Uthappa, and many others. We are elated to present them with the Best Educational Institute Promoting Sports in the category of a school. We have with us its co-founder, Mr. Srinivasan, to receive the award. So I'll request him to speak a few words here. Do we have Mr. Srinivasan?
Srinivasan, on mute. Mr. Srinivasan, you're on mute, please. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Good evening, everyone. Okay. It's indeed a great privilege to be in the same platform as Mr. Gopichand, who has been our mentor and our advisor in this journey. And in fact, we were the last year's best startup awardee in FICCI Sports Award. And to get this as a best promoting school this year is fairly honor to us. And coming from the background of the only sport I played is playing in the same ground as Mr. Kumble, and thinking that we'll also do something in the sport arena is the only thing I did. But what we have done is, as the chairperson had briefed in the morning, because sport has to become a way of life. is the only way we think is to ensure that the academics and sport go in hand in hand and help a budding sports person in whether it is on the best in class infrastructure or build to create champions on the education side. So that is what we are attempting. And thank you, jury, and thanks everybody, all my partners, and all our students. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. And yes, we have with us the Secretary General Fiki, Shri Dilip Shenoyji. He's here with us. I'll request him to speak a few words here before we conclude. And when I say before we conclude, I would also want, if all of you are still there, we can probably switch on our cameras and maybe we can take a screenshot of all the winners together. I mean, that would be great if it's possible. So over to you, sir.
Thank you, Deeksha. First of all, congratulate all the winners. Before that, we need to get
sir.
Zahid to try and
sir, wo main bol raha tha to wo keh rahe ke log out karke log in kariye, aapki awaz nahi aa rahi hai.
Now we can hear you, Tashin. We can yes. hear you. Please go ahead.
Yes. Okay. This is my bad. He's joined us back, and so yes, we would first like to Tehsin ji se kuch yahan pe hum. One of the winners is joined back. So, aap se pehle sunenge, fir of course, we'll come back to the Secretary General, sir. Haji.
Over to you. Unmute yourself and give your acceptance speech, please. Are you to unmute yourself?
Tehsin ji, aapko microphone aapka fir se band ho gaya. Aapko usko bas unmute karna hai. Tehsin ji, आप अगर सुन पा रहे हैं तो आपकी स्क्रीन पे नीचे होगा आप वहां पे क्लिक करेंगे माइक्रोफोन का जो आइकन होगा उस पे आप क्लिक कर दें एक बार और फिर अनम्यूट हो जाएगा फिर वो रेड में होगा आप क्लिक करेंगे तो वो ग्रीन हो जाएगा आई थिंक ही इज So he's struggling with the pandemic and the after effects of battling with the pandemic on a virtual platform. I think he's. I'll request Shri Dilip Shenoy to Secretary General of FICCI to speak a few words here, in case by then Tehsin ji has been able to
thank
figure
you,
out.
Thank you so much. I just wanted to yes. say thank you to the chair of the jury and the members of the jury for helping us arrive at the winners. Thank you all the people who actually. Congratulations to each and every one of the winners. Thank you for being here today. I've had the pleasure of meeting some of you in person. And for me, each one of you is a role model. Some of you, like Dr. Amit Bhalla, have a grievance with me that I've not yet visited his institution. But the lockdown came before that. But I promise that I will visit each one of your academies and institutions and try and meet with as many of you as possible. I think your presence and your being here with us give all of us at FICCI a tremendous source of encouragement. So thank you, each one of you, for being here. I was not on the program, but I just requested 1.5 minutes just to say thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And if we can quickly, if all of us, at least those of us who are here. Haji.
Everyone, I'm so thankful to the jury, and especially I'm thankful to Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, Vicky, Mr. Shenoy, for this jury award which has been given to sports here. It has been a wonderful experience in the last 6 months when we started it, building it, this platform, and within 3 months we were able to launch it. And this was entirely a quick platform which came into the system. Just outset. And I'm also very thankful to National Skill Development Corporation for supporting me in all this endeavor. And special thanks to Pulela Ji, who is also present in this conference, who has supported in all my venture into this sports grid. And he has given his various inputs on what to build it up. And once again, thank you all of you. I'm sorry for the technical issues that came into my time. But thank you so much. And awards bring more responsibilities that I'm sure. And I'm probably looking forward for much more than this platform and sport. Thank you all once again.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. And before we wrap this up and I say a formal thank you to everyone, if we can switch on our cameras and maybe we can have a nice picture. We all can do it with our, we can use our mobile phones as well to click for ourselves and of course, one for the memory of it for having conducted this so nicely, even on a virtual platform. So I'll request everyone if they can switch on their videos for a while. Well, I'm sure, of course, some of them are probably close to dinner time as well. So I can understand when you're doing an event from home on a virtual platform. So nevertheless, thank you, everyone, first of all, congratulations to all the winners once again, India Sports Awards 2020. You all make us so, so proud. And thank you to particularly, I would like to thank our award partner, MPL. You know, it's been, Himanshu Ji was here with us once again, thank you. And without the support of partners and, our Mobile Premier League, MPL award partner, thank you so much. All our partners, sponsors, our supporters, those who have been with Fiki during these trying times, thank you everyone for your wonderful support. Thank you to all the awardees who have joined us virtually from different parts of the country and some also from abroad. We just had somebody from the USA training and joining on this virtual platform as well. So thank you, everyone. It's been a pleasure to have you all here. And once again, congratulations. God bless you and good night. Thank you, everyone. Namaskar.